down her arms to be recognized as free. The whole world seems well satisfied, and well they ought to be. No nation ever did her fit to help her sisters out. Like this green plant we seldom see, but hear so much about. But now when everything is looking bright, what have we left to argue on should Ireland cease to fight? There's Irish on our fleet floor, there's Irish on our car, there's Irish on the ferry boat since they've cut out the bar. There's Irish in our city hall to help you when in jail. There's Irish who you'll find the first to get you out on bail. There's Irish on your voting list and at the poll. There's Irish at the bridges when you pay your toll. But if you thirst to be the first in any kind of fight, just argue with an Irishman. Then kiss yourself goodnight. There are Casey's and O'Briens and Mulkeys and McGill you will find in any town where you go. There's the Drogans and the Hogans and the Coogans and the Dugans who will always stop them laughing at the show. There's McGinnis's and Cunninis's and Hopers and O'Neill who love to see the ketchup in their beans. There's the Milans and the Nilans and the greater New York Highlands who will find the Keiths and Nichols in your jeans. There's the Heelys and the Breezys and the Keelys and the Beelys who will start a fight when nobody's involved. It's the Dairies and the Careys and the Dairies and the Dairies are the coppers who will send them when to halt. But it's the Corbett and the Sullivans, the Dempseys and McCoys who really know the proper way to fight. So pick a little argument with any of these mixed. Then kiss yourself good night. There's the Coens and the Murphys and the Biscuits and McGurk's selling peanuts every summer at the shore. And there's the Leopolds and Lovelies and the Harrises and Downies. There are names you'll find on any clothing store. There's the Einsteins and O'Connors and the Bernsteins and the Bays who find their best to do the thing that's right. And the Zerlingers and Dillinghams, the Frohmans and the Wavers who would pass you in the theater any night. There's the Silversteins and Sweeneys and the Goldsteins and the Feenies in the life of pure waiting to be wed. And it's the Goldbergs and the Hardys and the Ginsbergs and McCarthy's are the writers writing everything that's said. But it's the Corbett's and the Dempsey's, the Lennon's and Levinsky's who really know the proper way to fight. So pick a little argument with any of these mixed and lumber for the night.